returning to a semblance of normality as trains begin rolling into Parsons Green subway station once again. Open for business, but security supercharged as the terror threat level is notched up a gear.
The UK Prime Minister made her decision to raise the terror alert to critical, its highest level, following an emergency meeting of the Joint Terrorism Analysis Centre, a body made up of experts from government, the police, and Britain's intelligence agencies. What it means, of course, is that in their view, and in the view of the Prime Minister, another terrorist attack could be imminent.
For this period, military personnel will replace police officers on guard duties at certain protected sites which are not accessible to the public. The public will see more armed police on the transport network and on our streets, providing extra protection.
Scotland Yard's Assistant Commissioner Mark Rowley says troops at key positions will enable him to position on the streets another 1,000 armed police. In the south coast port of Dover, one of Britain's main connecting ports to the European mainland, an 18-year-old man has been detained by police in connection with the bombing at Parsons Green. It was after the Manchester bombing in May, when 22 people were killed, that Britain's terror alert was last raised to critical. The bombing at Parsons Green, the fifth terror attack in the UK this year.
I think it's a good thing, but it does give us some sense of fear, especially travelling on the tube.
I'm just going to put everybody into a panic.
I trust the government that they're making the right decision to put the level up to critical. They obviously have far more information than I do.
There's no indication yet from the Prime Minister's office as to what impact this arrest in Dover will have on the country's security alert levels. However, it is an indication of the speed at which the security forces are working in this investigation. Richard Bestic, CGTN, Downing Street, London.